This summer, I participated in a workshop. I worked with a Spanish and Colombian collective, and our project was to visualize data about the mobility of Spanish art, where expositions of Spanish exhibitions of Spanish art come from, where they go to, how much they cost. So we did this, and we revealed a soft power network of institutions that dominate the exchange of Spanish art. So the way, this is still work in progress, by the way. So the way we did that was not a novelty, but however, it is still an interesting topic to work on, because this data was not available before. It has not been visualized before, so that's why it is apparently an interesting problem. So we decided to try to work this out. We were not sure how we would get the data, because Spanish art is interesting in itself, but it is something very expensive because it is also very popular. So public, private galleries are not prone to giving data, to releasing data. So we could try to convince them by saying them that visualization has become something popular and it is apparently a good thing. It's better to do it than not to do it. But it things don't work this way. It's never that simple. So we also had to give the argument that data visualization is about presenting hard data and not an opinion about the world. It's about trying to be as objective as one can be, presenting an aspect of the data. So the big guy of our field has broken down the visualization procedure in steps. So there is a lot of talk about the technical stuff, but acquiring data that's there on the top is not talked about, and it's not trivial. You don't just walk in the Spanish government and say, get them data, fetch me them data. The answer is usually no. So we were getting the no's from them, and we had trouble what to do. We could pay to get the data, but even in countries that have a Freedom of Information Act, closed data cost a lot of money. It's very expensive to get data. So actually, we didn't have this option because we were in a project that had no budget. So we asked the wise guys what to do, and their advice was to work with what was available. That's a fair thing to do if you are interested in visualization itself, but we were also interested in Spanish art. So we were very frustrated with the whole situation, and we decided to do something about it. And we did that in the summer, so it was a very good period to do some action, to take the things in our own hands. So we went to the actual museums and we did some interviews, and we said the right people to do the interviews, because we live in a sexist world and not everybody can get the data. Some people get a no, some people get a yes. So we put the big smiles, we got some data, we started sketching like crazy to see what we can do with them data. And in the process, we were getting more data. So we were familiarizing ourselves, and we were using a software called Processing to create tangible prototypes of what our visualizations might look like. So we had something really tangible to work on. And in the meanwhile, we were getting more data, and we were trying to depict objectively what the data were saying to us. So we kind of made it. We made the visualizations I present in the beginning through all these iterations. And so we actually opened the data we got ourselves. So they're online, they're publicly available. You can go and check if we did a good job. You can go and check if we are objective enough. You can visualize yourself other aspects of the data. So what we found out is that you can wait for the big guys to open data, but more often than not, it doesn't happen. It's a very rare thing, and it will not fit your problem in general. It's very generic data that exists out there. So if you actually want to work for a problem, do a map of what and where you want to go and get the actual data and make them available, open the data yourself. It's cheap, it's fast, it's reliable, and it works. And then you can actually visualize them, see if good job has been done, and reveal new meaning to the data to find out what it's all about. That was it. No Father Ted.